Night shift is about a group of doctors that work at a San Antonio hospital during the night hours, I'd say from 6 or 7 at night to 6 or 7 in the morning. And it's basically all the mayhem that ensues when the crazy people come out at night, and a lot of funny stories, a lot of heartwarming stories. It's just the group of doctors that are some from the military, some just regular doctors coming together trying to save lives. Yeah. My character on the night shift is Paul Cummings. He's a very young intern at the hospital, so a year one resident. And the first episode of the show is my first day on the job. And, he's kind of coming into his own as a doctor and learning from all the other characters like TC and even Brenda's character, Drew. And so he's basically kind of picked on, but in a fun way, because it's just an initiation thing that you go through in the hospital, learning the ropes and having a bit of fun with it. So I think in that way, he has a lot to do with the humor in the show, because he's a lot of the situations are at his expense, but in a fun way. So the fact that we have humor in our show definitely sets it apart, because it's realistic in that way, that in an actual ER, I feel there are definitely tragedies all the time, but there's a lot of humor right next to it, and it's a weird combination that you don't really find anywhere else. So I think we really bring that to light, that even though there's always these dramatic situations going on, there's a lot of lighthearted comedy as well, just in everyday moments, you know? So I think we definitely bring that element, and I think people are gonna really enjoy it. You have everything from people that have drug addictions that are, you know, going through withdrawal or something like that, to people that have inserted foreign objects into their body in different ways. So those are always fun cases. And of course you have the regular flus or, you know, cold, that sort of thing. But there's always really interesting people that come in, you know, something about night, everybody decides to come out, you know. Our real life consultants have been amazing, like Susie and Dr. Zach. We basically go to them during every scene and are just constantly asking, like, how would I go about doing this, or what, does this look normal? You know, sometimes we have weird ideas as actors what we might want to do, and it's just like, no, that wouldn't actually happen. It is on this huge soundstage. I'd say it's larger than normal, and basically every wall or panel we have can be, you know, taken out, or you can slide it over, so you can get really cool shots, and you can kind of just move throughout the set without ever really taking a break, and it allows us to get the most amazing shots. And you can expect to see the unexpected, I'd say. I think every time we get a story, it's always amazing what goes into it, and you're just like, really, we're doing that? Okay. I think it's just incredibly fun. Every episode we're doing something crazy big, and we're going to some interesting place, and a place you really wouldn't expect us to be, and we're, you know, saving or trying to save lives, so.
My character, I play Paul Cummings. He is a first year resident, so he's kind of thrown into the craziness and has no clue what's going on for the most part. A lot of these stories are actually from actual doctors that work even at after-hours clinics, and they talk about the really insane, crazy, intense cases that come in, and so they're based on that. So it's more relaxed in certain aspects as far as maybe rules go, because there's a lot of things going on at night that maybe wouldn't happen during the daytime. So you kind of are flying by the seat of your pants and trying to make things work. And we actually had to watch a surgery going on yesterday, and it looked very real. And if you're not into that sort of thing, you can get kind of squeamish. So I'd say it's pretty accurate, and it's going to be really cool to watch on screen. Because of everything that's going on at night with all the accidents, and, you know, there's tragedy all around, you have to keep humor going in order to make it through that. Anybody would go crazy with so much intensity at all times. Necessary to, you know, tell jokes and have friends and be close as a family in the hospital in order to, you know, do the best you can do and hope for the best, I guess. I don't know.